Hello students, hope you are all well. Okay, so today we are again going to continue with the same chapter. A chapter here is number system. Okay, we were discussing number system, and what we have discussed till now, in number system we have discussed that there are some real numbers. Real numbers are categorized broadly into rational numbers and irrational numbers. When the real numbers can be represented in the form of P by Q, then they are called rational numbers. Otherwise, they are called irrational numbers. Now, this P by Q form is here P, both P and Q are integers. Okay. So, today we are going to study a little bit about irrational numbers. So, let's see what are irrational numbers. If the number cannot be represented cannot be represented in the form of P by Q, then it is called an irrational number. Then it is called an irrational number. Okay. Once again, I'm going to remind you that here I'm not writing it, but it is to be understood by you that both P and Q are supposed to be integers. Both P and Q are supposed to be integers. You cannot say root 2 upon 1 is an rational number or irrational number. Okay. Root 2 upon 1 is not a rational number. Why? Because under root 2 is not. Under root 2 is not an integer. Okay. So these types of numbers are rational numbers. Let us take some examples. Okay. Some examples, any prime number under the square root or any non-perfect number under the square root. Okay. Under root 2, it is an irrational number. Under root 8. Under root 8, if we simplify under root 8, we will get 2 root 2. Once again, root 2 is remaining. If the number is root mein, then it is an irrational number. Okay. Similarly, you have cube roots. Numbers in cube roots can also be irrational. But as you might know, that is not in our course. Okay. Also, under root 5, under root 32, 125, all these are irrational numbers. And this irrational number concept is not limited to just that. Also, you know a term pi. You know a term pi. You write it as 3.14 something. Okay, for some calculation purposes, you also write it as 22 upon 7. Let me remind you again, 22 upon 7 is an approximate. Value of pi. Same goes with 3.14. 3.14 is also an approximate value of pi. These are not exact value of pi. We take 3.14 or 22 upon 7 to ease the calculation. Taken to simplify the calculation. Taken to simplify the calculations. Okay. So these type of numbers are irrational numbers. Okay. We are in your second exercise, we are going to learn how to represent irrational number on the number line. In our second exercise, exercise 1.2, we are going to learn how to represent irrational numbers on number line. Okay. So our topic now is going to be representation of irrational numbers on number line. Okay, first of all, before we start with the topic, we need to have a firm grasp on Pythagoras theorem. So, first of all, let us write down the statement of Pythagoras theorem. फॉर एनी राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल, फॉर एनी राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल फॉर एनी राइट एंगल ट्राइंगल द वैल्यू ऑफ ऑफ स्क्वायर ऑफ हाइपोटेनियस द वैल्यू ऑफ स्क्वायर ऑफ हाइपोटेनियस इज ऑलवेज इक्वल टू is always equal to sum of square of base and perpendicular, or we can say sum of square of other two sides. What we are saying is, suppose we have this right angle triangle A, B, C, and this angle, angle B is 90 degree. So, what will be the Pythagoras theorem? We will have Pythagoras theorem as square of hypotenuse. What is hypotenuse? The side opposite to 90 degree. The side opposite to 90 degree angle is hypotenuse. So, square of hypotenuse, AC square, is equals to sum of square of other two sides. Other two sides are AB and BC. Sum of squares of other two sides. So this is what the Pythagoras theorem is. Now we need to understand how we are going to apply this concept in our problems. Okay. I'll just start with the question, and along with the question, I will introduce Pythagoras theorem where it is required. Okay. So the thing that we now need to do is that is the part of construction. Okay, so let's start. This is a question. Under root 2, under root 3, under root 5, all these three questions are part of your NCERT. Okay, you can also try different other questions. Okay, but we just going through the NCERT today. Under root 2, under root 3, and under root 5, we have to represent following numbers on the number. Okay. So we will represent, we will do these types of question in two ways. First of all, we will practically represent the numbers on the number line. Okay. Once we are done with that, we are going to support our statement, support what we have practiced using some theory. Okay. For theory, once again, I'm going to use Pythagoras here. Okay. So let us start with under root 2. First is under root. So, first of all, what you need to do is you need to draw a number. Let me make this line a bit thicker. First of all, what you need to do is you need to draw a number line. Okay. Now, the question being, how much longer should the number line be? Okay. So, let's just say I'm taking a number line of 1 centimeter. I'm interested in a number line of 1 centimeter. You extend it up to 5 centimeters. 5 centimeters, 3 centimeters, it is up to you. You have to draw a number line more than 2 centimeters. Okay. You have to draw a number line more than 2 centimeters. Okay. First of all, you mark this 0, 0 as A point. Okay. Now, what you need to do is you need to take a 1 centimeter line. You need to draw 1 centimeter line from A to B, like this. Suppose this is 1 centimeter. You need to draw 1 centimeter line from A to B. Okay, so this point will be B. Now I'm going to write it here, AB. Here AB is equals to 1 centimeter. Remember, what I'm doing is I'm trying to plot under root 2. Okay, first of all, you see the diagram, you see the procedure, and afterward, I will explain it more clearly with the help of theory and pathways. Okay. So, what we need to do is, first of all, we take a reference point A on this line, and then we draw AB is equals to 170. Now, what we need to do is, we need to draw perpendicular from point B. We need to draw perpendicular from point B. Okay. I want to draw a line perpendicular to this line from B. Okay. So for perpendicular, what you can do is you can easily take your D or you can use compass. It is up to you. You can use your compass or your D. Okay. So I'm drawing the perpendicular here. Okay, this is the perpendicular here. Okay, let's extend it a bit. Let's try one more time. First of all, I will draw a perpendicular here. Sorry. Yes. This I extended the perpendicular. Okay. Okay, now what I'm going to do is on this perpendicular, I am going to mark 1 centimeter. What I am going to do is, I am going to open a compass of 1 centimeter, open the compass of 1 centimeter and mark an arc of it. Okay, how do you open the compass of 1 centimeter? You take the compass of 1 centimeter. How do you take the compass of 1 centimeter? You put the point of the compass at point A. You put the point of the compass at point A and pencil at B. Okay? That way you get 1 centimeter from A to B and then you put on an arc of 1 centimeter on this perpendicular. Let us say this point is C. Now what we need to do is, now what we have is, now listen, what we have is, we have a base of 1 centimeter as well as an height of 1 centimeter. This angle, angle B here is 90 degrees. Now what we are going to do is, we are going to extend, yeah, you can say we are going to join the lines between A and C. We are going to join points A and C. See, like this. We are going to join point A and C, and after this, I'm going to claim that this AC is equal to under root 2 centimeter. I'm going to claim that this AC is equal to under root 2 centimeter. Okay, so let's see the theory behind it. See, for triangle ABC, if triangle ABC is a right angle triangle, that must mean AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square. For triangle ABC, why so? Pythagoras theorem. Okay, this is because of Pythagoras theorem. So AC square is equals to AB square plus BC square. Now, AC square will be equal to AB. AB is 1 centimeter plus BC is 1 centimeter. Now, square of 1 is 1 and square of 1 is 1. So, this will be 2. So, what we have till now is AC square, square of a number is equals to 2. We have square of a number is equals to 2. Taking square root on both sides, taking square roots on both sides, we will get finally AC is equals to under root. See, this is what I told you. I claimed that AC is equals to under root 2 when my base was 1 centimeter and my height was 1 centimeter. For any right triangle, if your base is 1 centimeter, your height is 1 centimeter, then in that case, your hypotenuse is going to be under root 2. Okay. Now, we have to do one final thing. What we need to do is, we have to put the compass on point A. We have to put the compass point on point A and pencil on point C. We have to put the point of compass on point A and pencil on point C. And after that, what we need to do is, we need to move the compass in this circular manner. We need to move the compass in this circular manner and it will cut an arc on our original line. And it will cut an arc on our original line. We'll mark this point as D and we will say that AD is equals to under root 2 centimeter. Okay. I hope you get it clearly. Let's try next one, under root 3. Next one is quite tricky. So for the next part, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to show you the theory first of all. After that, you will draw the diagram. Okay. So for under root 3, what we need to do? We need to remember for under root 3 what we need to do. Let's say for under root 3. Okay, for under root 3, let's take a rough diagram. Once again, we are going to use this right angle triangle once again. Suppose this right angle triangle, let's say it's PQR, right angle at Q. Okay, so we will have PQ square is equals to, we will have PR square is equals to PQ square plus QR square. Okay, so if I want PR as under root 3, then what I require is PR square should be equal to 3. Then what I require is PR square should be equal to 3. So what I need is, I need two such numbers whose square is equals to 3. Let's say, let's start with the simplest one. If PQ is 1 and QR is 1, then 1 square plus 1 square, that will be 2. Okay, that is not what I required. Okay, let's increase the value of one of the numbers. Let's say one number is 2, another number is 1. So 1 square plus 2 square, that will be 4 plus 1, that will be 5. Not required once again. Okay, so this is a conundrum that we have to face. Let's gamble a bit. Let's take QR as under root 2. Okay, let's see what happens. If PQ is 1 centimeter and QR is under root 2 centimeter, as we have already done it, we already know how to draw under root 2 centimeter on the number line. So what we did was, we take PQ as 1 centimeter and QR is under root 2 centimeter. See, what happens is, PR square becomes 1 plus 2 and PR square becomes 3. Once we have PR square is 3, then we can say that, taking square root on both sides, PR will be equal to root. Okay. So, by this theory, you might gather, in order to draw under root 3 on the number line, in order to represent under root 3 on the number line, what you need to do is, you need to first of all plot under root 2. First of all, you need to plot under root 2 and after that you draw under root 3. Okay. So, let's start with it. Let's start with it, okay? First of all, let us draw a number line. Once again, your number line is going to be, I will draw it this way. Your number line is good. Sorry, my bad. Your number line is going to be nearly 5 centimeter. Okay. You have to make a number line more than 3 centimeter. Okay. Apart from that, you can extend it up to you. Okay. So first of all, we'll start with root 2. So what did we do for root 2? We marked a point A, and from point A, we took a line of 1 centimeter. From point A, we took a line of 1 centimeter. Okay. What did we do with this line? At the end of the line, we mark point P. At the end of the line, we mark point P. And what do we do? We drew a perpendicular from point B. This is the perpendicular from point B. And we mark 1 centimeter on it. So how do we mark 1 centimeter on it? We took the compass. We took the compass and we put an arc of 1 centimeter. And we mark that point as C. This point as C. Now, finally, what we have, we join A and C. Finally, what we do is we join A and C. Let us draw it more clearly. Finally, I join A and C. Okay, so in this manner, I get AC is equals to. Okay, now what we need is, according to a theory, we need a base of under root 2. And height of 1 centimeter. We already gathered a base of under root 2. AC is under root 2. Okay, so what we need to do now is, we need to draw a line perpendicular to AC. We need to draw a line perpendicular to AC from point C. See, this is your line AC. You have to draw another line perpendicular to AC. Perpendicular to the AC means like this. You have to draw a line perpendicular to AC. So your line should be like this. See, the angle here between AC and the new line. The angle here between AC and the new line is 90 degrees. Get it? The angle between AC and the new line is 90 degrees. And what you need to do is, you need to place that 1 centimeter arc again from point C. See, like this. I put that 1 centimeter arc that was equal to AB or from point C. Okay. In this manner, we get another point. Let's name this point as B. Finally, what you need to do is, finally, you join A and D and you get your required under root 3. When I join A and D, I get required under root 3. So, what I'm saying is, first of all, I drew, AB is equals to 1 centimeter. Then I drew BC is equals to 1 centimeter. By all this, I got AC is equals to under root 2. Okay. After that, once I have AC is equals to under root 2, सेंटीमीटर एंड सी डी इज इक्वल टू 1 सेंटीमीटर फ्रॉम दिस कॉम्बिनेशन आई गॉट ए डी दैट वॉज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट 3. ओके नाउ फाइनली वॉट यू नीड टू डू इज यू नीड टू पुट योर कंपास एट पॉइंट ए एंड पेंसिल एट योर पॉइंट डी एंड यू हैव टू एक्सटेंड एन आर्क. This arc is going to be a bit larger than what we did in under root 2, okay? And that you mark point E and finally you say that AE is equals to under root 3. I hope it is clear. If it not, please play the video again. Okay, you have to draw these diagrams in your copies. If you have any other method to draw these diagrams, if you have any other method to plot root 2, root 3, root 5, you can also use them. Okay, lastly, you have under root 5. So, lastly, let's do this one quickly for under root 5. Okay, for under root 5, see, for any number that is just after a perfect square. For any number that is just after a perfect square. After 1, 1 is a perfect square, you got 2. So what you did was, you take base as 1, you take one side as 1, another side as number less than 2. That is, okay, after that we have a perfect square 4. So after perfect square 4, we have another number as 5. So for the case of under root 5, what we are going to do, we are going to take one side as 1 centimeter and another side as square root of 4. Square root of 4 is 2. So we are going to take one side as 1 centimeter, another side as 2 centimeter, and this will provide us with the solution. Okay. So I will start the construction first of all. First of all, again, same thing. We will draw a number line. Now this time you draw a number line nearly 5 centimeter, and we will start with point A. We will start with point A. Okay, I will take a line, another line of 1 centimeter. Sorry, let's take 2 centimeter at the base this time. I will take A to B 2 centimeter. I will take A to B 2 centimeter. What I'm taking is AB is equals to 2 centimeter. Okay, fine. After this, I will draw once again a line perpendicular to AB from point B. I will draw a line perpendicular to AB from point B. This is a perpendicular line. I will mark an arc of 1 centimeter. I will mark an arc of 1 centimeter. Okay. So let's draw this 1 centimeter. This becomes 1 centimeter. Let me name this point as C. This point becomes C. This point becomes C. Finally, what we need to do is, we need to extend A to C. We need to extend A to C, and thus we get AC is equals to, and thus we get AC is equals to under root 3 centimeter. Here AB was 2 centimeter. You can interchange the length of AB and BC. I've taken base as 2 centimeter. If you want to take base as 1 centimeter, you have to take the height as 2 centimeter. The value of base and perpendicular are interchangeable for this case. Okay. And finally, you know what to do. You will extend, you will take your compass point at point A and your pencil at point C, and you will extend it on the number line, marking a point E and finally saying AE is equals to under root 3 centimeter. Okay. I hope you can perform the Pythagoras theorem theory about it as well. Okay. Well, then that's it for today. Try exercise 1.2. Try exercise 1.2 in your copy. We have completed the representation question. You have to just do the theory questions. Okay. And lastly, the last question of the exercise is not required. The last question of the exercise is not compulsory. That is for your practice purpose. Okay. So thank you for your time. Have a nice day.